Charging our phone is an activity that we do daily, but we could still improve on it. Hello guys, I'm Shlok and for this video, we'll need a banana, a wire and... Just kidding, in this video, I will show you some real charging tricks that will make your phone charge faster and also some cool gadgets that will definitely be very useful. So let's start by doing some simple things. First of all, turn on airplane mode on your phone. It will make your phone charge faster. Turning on airplane mode turns off all the services like the SIM network that make the phone use less battery and also not heat up while charging. And this in turn makes your phone charge a lot faster. You can also power off your phone while charging it, but that definitely won't work on an iPhone. And make sure if you're using an Android phone, you have charging set in the USB configuration menu. To do that, you'll have to go to the settings menu, then about phone, and then tap on the build number 7 times. This will enable the developer options and then you'll have to go inside the developer options and select the USB configuration. It will have a lot of options like media transfer, picture transfer, Ethernet, audio source or MIDI. You have to select charging because this will optimize your phone for charging while on the USB and of course this will impact the charging time by a little bit. Now we all love wireless charging but it is still not compatible with a lot of phones right now. What if I tell you can wirelessly charge any phone right now even if it doesn't have wireless charging? This would work for all phones, you just need a wireless adapter like this and it can plug in directly to your micro USB adapter or you can even buy one for iPhone. After putting this on the back of your phone magically now has wireless charging and now you can use it with almost any kind of wireless charger. You just have to place your phone on the wireless charger and voila, it will start charging. This is actually very thin and not noticeable at all and if you plug it into your micro USB port and hide it behind the back of your phone, most people won't even realize that you have some kind of gadget plugged into your device. And it's not a charging mechanism, it is just a receiver module, so it will not impact the charging speed. You can see I have plugged this into the Jio phone and it doesn't even have fast charging and it works flawlessly on this phone as well. Now one thing that I think everyone should do while charging their phone is remove their back cover. When your phone charges, it heats up a bit and to keep the temperature stable, the phone actually reduces the charging speed. If the temperature rises above a certain limit, then the phone will automatically stop charging. It will show you the charging time, but the phone will charge very slowly. And this is not just for charging. This process is called thermal throttling and it works for performance the same way. So that's why if your phone becomes warm, it starts to lag a lot and also charge slowly because to make up for the temperature rise, it has to turn down the charging speed and also the performance at the same time. So if you put the back cover while charging your device, it will make the device a bit more warmer and this will also in turn reduce the charging speed. And it goes the same for putting your phone in a warm place as well. I'm not telling you to put your phone in a fridge or put ice over your battery, but definitely try to put your phone where the heat can be dissipated properly. So before moving on to the next trick, if you have not subscribed to this channel, make sure to press the subscribe button because I'll be making a lot more content like this. You can actually charge your phone using this solar charger and I know when I say solar, everybody is like this will be hell slow, but it's actually comparable to a normal charger. This one was sent to me by Blitzwolf and it's a lot better than other solar chargers that I've seen online. This is in shape of a bag and it has two solar panels that absorb electricity. You can hang this at any place that is getting direct sunlight or even if it's getting like good daylight, it will work. It has a USB port where you can plug two devices at once, but I would recommend you guys just plug one in it. You can also hang it on your backpack while you're moving around and your phone will automatically charge while you're even moving around. This one can charge a 3000 mAh battery to around 40% in about 1 hour if you're getting good daylight, but there is also a fast charging one on their website that can charge up to 60% in just 1 hour. This will work if you have decent lighting, but there is also one that has fast charging enabled on their website. So this one has two, the other one has multiple panels and that one can actually function as a fast charger. These will of course not be comparable to a power outlet, but they can be quite useful if you're going on long trips on a car. Now finally, some do's and don'ts about your charging. You should not use a low quality charger at any cost. These chargers can actually reduce the charging time permanently on your battery and they will also harm your phone as well. But they do have some plus points. they can double up as firecrackers, so make sure you save them for Diwali and don't use them every day for your phone. I'm not saying that you should not use a different brand charger. If the ampere rating is same, you can definitely use other brand chargers as well, but make sure they are certified. That goes the same for cables as well. You should definitely avoid using poor quality cables because they have high resistance, and no matter how good the charger is, if the cable is of poor quality, your phone will not charge fast. So get a decent cable and you will not be blaming your charger. You can charge your phone using a laptop or even your car, but I don't personally recommend it, not because it's harmful, but because it's slow. You are better off charging your phone from a power outlet because the laptop does not provide enough power for charging. And also one last thing, it does not matter if you charge your phone overnight or not, because as soon as your phone taps 100%, it starts to discharge even when it's plugged in, and then it goes back to like 90% or something, and then it starts to charge again. This cycle repeats so that the phone does not overcharge at all. So it's completely safe to put your phone on charge for long hours. If you guys want, I can also make a separate video about battery myths, but that was kind of it for this video guys. If you liked the video, make sure you press the subscribe button, and also you can watch some previous videos on this channel.